The reason why people are here is because this government is threatening to close our A&E in Roscommon on Monday. They said they're going to do it. We're here to try and put pressure on our local deputies in order that they actually stand by the people rather than standing by the Fine Gael party.
I have used Roscommon Hospital quite a lot, including in the last year when I rang them up on Good Friday night when I was feeling very bad, and I told them that I was on my way. I live 30 miles away from the hospital. We will show the politicians, you know, who speaks for the people, and we are not going to let this die.
We're up from Ballydrink and Roscommon to support our hospital. We don't want to lose our A&E, we don't want to lose our hospital, we don't want to lose people's lives on our way to Galway, and we're here to fight.
My A&E is actually Port Yonkla, but if the services are closed in Roscommon, then that's going to affect the surrounding services in Sligo, Galway and Port Yonkla. And this is important. These are people's lives that are at stake in the A&E service. I've been through the A&E service. It's already under strain. And the resources need to be put into the services.
We want the hospital services to be kept in place. We're not looking for anything extra. We just want to keep what we have. And it's a basic human right to have adequate health services.
I come to save, not to try, to save our hospital. We are entitled to our hospital. My brother was saved in it, my sister-in-law, my husband. I have been saved in it with the heart attacks. So I don't see why we're not entitled to our hospital. And I say boo to those TDs who promised us our hospital and stop people from voting for the Fianna, our hospital candidate with false promises. We're entitled to our hospital.
The spin in the last few days has been very, very hard to take. Even our own elected representatives have attempted to convince us that we would be better off without our A&E. And the GPs in our area have said the following. We are in no doubt that lives will be lost and patient outcomes will be adversely affected. Every GP in the catchment area of County Roscommon, Leitrim, Longford, Mayo, Galway, Westmeath and Sligo is appalled, and I say it again, is appalled at the proposed downgrading of the hospital and the effect it will have on patient care and safety. I looked at the Fine Gael website today and I discovered that Fine Gael are Christian Democrats. I also checked out the Ten Commandments, which Christians are meant to follow. The ninth commandment says, thou shalt not lie. If Fine Gael don't do as they promised in advance of the election, I challenge them here today to the fact that they are not Christian, nor are they Democrats.
They can hear us. We want them to hear us, and they better get their message. We want Roscommon lives saved.
See this? We landed in Hyde Park. We brought out 10,000 people in Hyde Park last August. We're here in Dublin. We're outside the door, and we have to go in. We will go in. Come on, Rossie!
People can take the truth if they're told it. And it's a shame that Fine Gael couldn't have come out and told us what they were planning before the election. Because the reality is, we now would have two independent TDs from Roscommon, South Leitrim and Dáil. And one of them is standing beside me here now.
People of Dublin, I'm going to make you an offer. I'm going to say, if you had a heart attack in Lucan, where would your A&E be on that basis? It wouldn't be the six that are here.
Blanche.
Your A&E would be in Barnslow in County Galway. Now, would somebody accept that as a service?
No.
We won't accept it as a service. The people of Dublin wouldn't accept it as a service. So it's the minimum we're asking for.
They might be early in their political five-year term here, but we won't forget this. Even in 4 years' time, we won't forget it!